Thank you. Thank you very much for being here this afternoon. Yeah, you mentioned even two of those files. We were able to reach an agreement yesterday, but there was also another file about Digital Euro program. And once again, just yesterday, we reached an agreement in this very important issue. So when dealing with bookkeeping, I'm happy to say that we were able to reach an agreement with 28 legislative files out of 30 already. I have to be happy, and I'm happy. Well, about copyright reform. I'm happy that we made a really remarkable step forward. So it was quite complicated to manage with those old-fashioned rules in digital area. And now we can say that in many areas people, they can have a look forward in a more optimistic way. I'm happy because of text and data mining. We can say that Europe has a leading position globally in meaning of scientific articles based on text and data mining. But this is mainly so because of the United Kingdom, because in the United Kingdom, scientists, entrepreneurs, they can fully use text and data mining, but in majority of EU member states, this very important instrument is not in hands of our scientists and our entrepreneurs. We have a dream to have a leading position in meaning of artificial intelligence globally, but if our developers will not have this really important instrument in their hands, how we will get this leading position in the field of artificial intelligence globally. So, according to those new rules, our scientists, our entrepreneurs, they can use fully text and data mining. I'm also happy because of our digital cultural heritage. As we all know, in our museums, in our archives, they have already millions of hours of cultural heritage, which is recorded on tapes, which is digital already. And at the same time, we know also that those TV series on tapes, one day, they will just disappear. This information will disappear. It will not last forever that those tapes will have really high quality, and there is a need. We have to protect our cultural heritage, which is digital already. For this, we have to make copies. But to make copies, at first, you have to clear rights. But just for 1 hour, for TV series, there can be 200 different right owners. And now there is a question. Do our museums and archives have enough funds to clear rights with 200 different right owners? I don't think so. So with this new set of rules, museums, they can make copies more easily, and we can say that, yes, our cultural heritage, which is digital already, will be preserved. Mandatory exceptions for teaching purposes, the same story. Some university professors, they have good presentations. Somebody will invite them to deliver a lecture in another country. But professors, they have some doubts because they are using some kind of copyrighted materials, and when they would like to go to some other universities in other countries, they have to start with from clearing rights. Of course, they have those 3 years to pay for FOTA, but it's too costly in meaning of administrative cost. It's about time and energy you had to put in this process, and in many situations, professors, they say, no, it's not for me. I prefer to stay at home. So I'm also happy that we were able to propose something which will really help also our creators. I'm talking about fair remuneration of our authors, Article 11 and Article 13. With Article 13, some people, they say that, oh, they are not able to understand about what kind of value gap they are talking about. I'll try to explain once again. There are two types of platforms. Platforms based on subscription. They had in the year 2016, according to McKinsey, 212 million subscribers. And those 212 million subscribers, they pay to musicians 3.9 billion US dollars globally. Musicians, they are not totally happy, but knowing that many of those platforms based on subscription are facing with losses, they have to agree. At the same time, there are some other platforms supported by ads. Those platforms, they had in the year 2016 even 900 million users. But those platforms paid to musicians just $553 million. And of course, musicians are unhappy. They say, look, there is a value cap. We expected to get 15 billion US dollars, but we got just half a billion dollars. It's not fair. Well, some people representing those platforms, they say that musicians, they have to be happy because millions and billions of people, they can get access to those masterpieces practically immediately. Musicians, they say, of course, we're really happy because of the internet. But fair remuneration is also important. We have families. They would like to eat. So we don't have to think that all the musicians, they are just stars. Majority of our creators, they are trying to survive. And this fair remuneration is definitely important also for those people who are in difficulties today. Article 11 about neighboring rights to press publishers. Well, in 1960s, last century, record labels, they got their neighboring rights. Press publishers, they didn't get those neighboring rights. Yeah, you can't agree, of course, that there is no difference between record labels and press publishers. But in fact, yeah, record labels, they had to invite drummers, singers, somebody who is taking care about recording to studio. And press publishers, they had to invite journalists, photographers, and somebody who is taking care about layouts. Not so big difference. Why record labels got their neighboring rights and press publishers didn't get their neighboring rights? Because press publishers, they didn't ask for those rights. At that time, it was easier to say that we're just neutral intermediaries, and those photographers, journalists, they have to be liable. Now, they are unhappy. They say that somebody else is using their content without providing fair remuneration for this. Well, I think it's a fair solution to provide also neighboring rights to press publishers. It will definitely help them to create better negotiating positions in relations with the big platforms. For me, it's really important to remember that hyperlinking will stay as one of those basic freedoms we have in the internet forever. It's not about link tax or hyperlink tax or what they are talking about. It's about fair remuneration. Of course, we had tough negotiations, and there were a lot of tensions, not only among those co-legislators, but all, it was about all the interested groups in the same way. But the result is quite good. It's a compromise, but it's a good compromise. I'm not happy that with this really important solution we were not able to make happy everybody. But I think majority of people, they are quite happy with this solution. Once again, a story about Copenhagen and their film institute. Once I was there, there was a lady sitting on my right hand. She delivered really impressive speech. She said, this stress I have, this was really a beautiful red dress. I bought from second-hand shop, and I paid 25 Danish crowns to get this dress. My car, she said, is the oldest and ugliest car in Copenhagen. When getting salary, it's enough to pay back those loans I took during the last year, month, and next day I have to start with new loans. Please change existing copyright legislation. She got really strong applause. Then a gentleman sitting on my left hand, his suit wasn't from second-hand shop, he was producer. He delivered also impressive speech. Don't touch our existing copyright legislation. It works well. And he got also strong applause. Then I thought, why I had to be here? Maybe they can somehow talk with each other. So those tensions, based on different interests, they will not disappear with those rules, but new rules, but I'm absolutely sure that those new rules will create a much better environment for our creators. And I would like to say that those new rules will provide also much better protection to our users. For our users, now there will be much more clarity. They can upload and they don't have to be afraid that uploading some kind of materials, they will get some punishment or whatever. Licensing, it's an obligation for platforms, not for users. Users are fully protected. Well, it was time for short questions also, but I thought that my introductory words, they will be short, so not questions. So I'm ready to take your questions.
And
there will be also technical brief, and you can raise all the question about technicalities later on. So when I will leave this stage, then it does not mean that it's over and no more information.